live on the air. Don't you worry about us. She's just directing people to their tables while we're doing. No, you're
really?
Good. Yeah, it's Kathleen Harrington, in case you didn't know, the president of the Chamber of Commerce in Rochester. But no, the funny thing is that you are like a conductor right now. Very busy, 950 people registered, and do you have enough seats?
Well, we think we have just enough seats, but maybe we're a few short. But you know what? This is a friendly crowd, Betsy, and they're going to enjoy one another. And maybe we'll play a little musical chairs tonight.
You did something different this year. Every year it has been a sit-down, more of a formal kind of banquet, recognizing businesses and that kind of thing. This you purposely did differently. Why is that?
Well, we did it differently. It's the business community, but it's also celebrating the whole community. We brought in local artists who are small business people too. We want to honor them, and we're exhibiting their work. We're bringing in local musicians. It's going to be a fun, entertaining night, short on speeches and long on fun.
And that's what people are saying. They're feeling that. Mm-hmm. It does have not just the venue that has changed, the whole energy because mm-hmm. of the venue and what you bring to the chamber. You like to say that you're more about service than leading. Explain.
Well, the chamber's mission really is about service, serving the business community, which then creates a thriving community. So it's one and the same. So yes, we are about service. We help small businesses grow. We help sustain businesses. We help start. But we're all about the community and strengthening the entire community.
What are some of the things behind the scenes leading up to tonight and this event that people don't see, the things that maybe can be challenging for you?
Well, I think some of the things that were challenging for tonight's event was this is the first event in this venue.
Yeah.
So
they haven't even opened yet. They don't open until Tuesday.
They don't open yet. So this is the first event. It's the first event catering a dinner for 950 people, a buffet of great and different foods on two different floors. Mm-hmm. So we're wheeling in tables, carting in chairs, making sure we have enough, putting it all together in just a few days. So even on Monday, people were doing carpentry. So laying down carpet.
I can just see your face. I can imagine the stress you might have been through. Like, oh my God, that wall's got to be built.
But what's fun is to see everybody collaborating and pulling together.
Yeah.
When you just even look at the number of volunteers working here tonight, it is so exciting. And many of them are chamber members, ambassadors, but some of the others are community members that aren't members of the chamber. They might become someday all these local artists. But there's a different kind of connection going on, which is really exciting.
I needed to ask you about that because I'm seeing a lot of my friends in the nonprofits,
yes.
and it's important for them to be here,
yes.
because they then can connect with people who can help them,
mm-hmm.
Whether it's through the networking, through some kind of funding, through whatever. They have to have a place to get together, and that's what this is doing.
Absolutely. And that's part of our service mission too. We serve the nonprofits. Every month you'll notice we talk about in our magazine, we discuss one of the nonprofits. We have our network events at the nonprofit center, so the business people come and meet the nonprofits, understand what their philanthropic needs are, and connect. And again, strengthen the community.
I love it. Thank you, Kathleen.
Thank you.
We'll
Thanks
be right
for
back.
Being here.